Vienna Convention on Consular Relations 1963, Chapter 2, Section 2, Facilities, Privileges and Immunities Relating to Career Consular Officers and Other Members of a Consular Post, Article 40, Protection of Consular Officers. The receiving state shall treat consular officers with due respect and shall take all appropriate steps to prevent any attack on their person, freedom or dignity. Article 41, Personal Inviolability of Consular Officers. 1. Consular officers shall not be liable to arrest or detention pending trial, except in the case of a grave crime and pursuant to a decision by the competent judicial authority. 2. Except in the case specified in paragraph 1 of this article, consular officers shall not be committed to prison or be liable to any other form of restriction on their personal freedom save in execution of a judicial decision of final effect. 3. If criminal proceedings are instituted against a consular officer, he must appear before the competent authorities. Nevertheless, the proceedings shall be conducted with the respect due to him by reason of his official position and, except in the case specified in paragraph 1 of this article, in a manner which will hamper the exercise of consular functions as little as possible. When, in the circumstances mentioned in paragraph 1 of this article, it has become necessary to detain a consular officer, the proceedings against him shall be instituted with the minimum of delay. Article 42, Notification of Arrest, Detention or Prosecution, in the event of the arrest or detention, pending trial, of a member of the consular staff, or of criminal proceedings being instituted against him, the receiving state shall properly notify the head of the consular post. Should the latter be himself the object of any such measure, the receiving state shall notify the sending state through the diplomatic channel. Article 43, Immunity from Jurisdiction. 1. Consular officers and consular employees shall not be amenable to the jurisdiction of the judicial or administrative authorities of the receiving state in respect of acts performed in the exercise of consular functions. 2. The provisions of paragraph 1 of this article shall not, however, apply in respect of a civil action either. A. Arising out of a contract concluded by a consular officer or consular employee in which he did not contract expressly or impliedly as an agent of the sending state, or B. By a third party for damage arising from an accident in the receiving state caused by a vehicle, vessel or aircraft. Article 44, Liability to Give Evidence. 1. Members of a consular post may be called upon to attend as witnesses in the course of judicial or administrative proceedings. A consular employee or member of the service staff shall not, except in the cases mentioned in paragraph 3 of this article, decline to give evidence. If a consular officer should decline to do so, no coercive measure or penalty may be applied to him. 2. The authority requiring the evidence of a consular officer shall avoid interference with the performance of his functions. It may, when possible, take such evidence at his residence or at the consular post or accept a statement from him in writing. 3. Members of a consular post are under no obligation to give evidence concerning matters connected with the exercise of their functions or to produce official correspondence and documents relating thereto. They are also entitled to decline to give evidence as expert witnesses with regard to the law of the sending state. Article 45, Waiver of Privileges and Immunities. 1. The sending state may waive, with regard to a member of the consular post, any of the privileges and immunities provided for in Articles 41, 43 and 44. 2. The waiver shall in all cases be express, except as provided in paragraph 3 of this article, and shall be communicated to the receiving state in writing. 3. The initiation of proceedings by a consular officer or consular employee in a matter where he might enjoy immunity from jurisdiction under Article 43 shall preclude him from invoking immunity from jurisdiction in respect of any counterclaim directly connected with the principal claim. 4. The waiver of immunity from jurisdiction for the purposes of civil or administrative proceedings shall not be deemed to imply the waiver of immunity from the measures of execution resulting from the judicial decision in respect of such measures. A separate waiver shall be necessary. Article 46, Exemption from Registration of Aliens and Residence Permits. 1. consular officers and consular employees and members of their families forming part of their households shall be exempt from all obligations under the laws and regulations of the receiving state in regard to the registration of aliens and residence permits. 2. The provisions of paragraph 1 of this article shall not, however, apply to any consular employee who is not a permanent employee of the sending state or who carries on any private gainful occupation in the receiving state or to any member of the family of any such employee. Article 47, Exemption from Work Permits. 1. Members of the consular post shall, with respect to services rendered for the sending state, be exempt from any obligations in regard to work permits imposed by the laws and regulations of the receiving state concerning the employment of foreign labor. 2. Members of the private staff of consular officers and of consular employees shall, if they do not carry on any other gainful occupation in the receiving state, be exempt from the obligations referred to in paragraph 1 of this article. Article 48, Social Security Exemption. 1. Subject to the provisions of paragraph 3 of this article, members of the consular post with respect to services rendered by them for the sending state, and members of their families forming part of their households, shall be exempt from Social Security provisions which may be in force in the receiving state. 2. The exemption provided for in paragraph 1 of this article shall apply also to members of the private staff who are in the sole employ of members of the consular post, on condition A. that they are not nationals of or permanently resident in the receiving state and B. that they are covered by the Social Security provisions which are in force in the sending state or a third state. 3. Members of the consular post who employ persons to whom the exemption provided for in paragraph 2 of this article does not apply shall observe the obligations which the Social Security provisions of the receiving state impose upon employers. 4. The exemption provided for in paragraphs 1 and 2 of this article shall not preclude voluntary participation in the Social Security system of the receiving state, provided that such participation is permitted by that state. Article 49. Exemption from Taxation. 1. Consular officers and consular employees and members of their families forming part of their households shall be exempt from all dues and taxes, personal or real, national, regional or municipal, except A. indirect taxes of a kind which are normally incorporated in the price of goods or services. B. dues or taxes on private immovable property situated in the territory of the receiving state, subject to the provisions of Article 32. C. estate, succession or inheritance duties, and duties on transfers, levied by the receiving state, subject to the provisions of paragraph B. of Article 51. D. dues and taxes on private income, including capital gains, having its source in the receiving state and capital taxes relating to investments made in commercial or financial undertakings in the receiving state. E. charges levied for specific services rendered. F. registration, court or record fees, mortgage dues and stamp duties, subject to the provisions of Article 32. 2. Members of the service staff shall be exempt from dues and taxes on the wages which they receive for their services. 3. Members of the consular post who employ persons whose wages or salaries are not exempt from income tax in the receiving state shall observe the obligations which the laws and regulations of that state impose upon employers concerning the levying of income tax. Article 50. Exemption from customs duties and inspection. 1. The receiving state shall, in accordance with such laws and regulations as it may adopt, permit entry of and grant exemption from all customs duties, taxes, and related charges other than charges for storage, cartage and similar services, on A. articles for the official use of the consular post. B. articles for the personal use of consular officer or members of his family forming part of his household, including articles intended for his establishment. The articles intended for consumption shall not exceed the quantities necessary for direct utilization by the persons concerned. 2. Consular employees shall enjoy the privileges and exemptions specified in paragraph 1 of this article in respect of articles imported at the time of first installation. 3. personal baggage accompanying consular officers and members of their families forming part of their households shall be exempt from inspection. It may be inspected only if there is serious reason to believe that it contains articles other than those referred to in subparagraph B of paragraph 1 of this article, or articles the import or export of which is prohibited by the laws and regulations of the receiving state or which are subject to its quarantine laws and regulations. Such inspection shall be carried out in the presence of the consular officer or member of his family concerned. Article 51. Estate of a member of the consular post or of a member of his family. In the event of the death of a member of the consular post or of a member of his family forming part of his household, the receiving state A shall permit the export of the movable property of the deceased, with the exception of any such property acquired in the receiving state the export of which was prohibited at the time of his death. B shall not levy national, regional or municipal estate, succession or inheritance duties, and duties on transfers on movable property the presence of which in the receiving state was due solely to the presence in that state of the deceased as a member of the consular post or as a member of the family of a member of the consular post. Article 52. Exemption from personal services and contributions. The receiving state shall exempt members of the consular post and members of their families forming part of their households from all personal services, from all public service of any kind whatsoever, and from military obligations such as those connected with requisitioning, military contributions and billeting. Article 53, beginning and end of consular privileges and immunities. 1. Every member of the consular post shall enjoy the privileges and immunities provided in the present convention from the moment he enters the territory of the receiving state on proceeding to take up his post or, if already in its territory, from the moment when he enters on his duties with the consular post. 2. Members of the family of a member of the consular post forming part of his household and members of his private staff shall receive the privileges and immunities provided in the present convention from the date from which he enjoys privileges and immunities in accordance with paragraph 1 of this article or from the date of their entry into the territory of the receiving state or from the date of their becoming a member of such family or private staff, whichever is the latest. 3. When the functions of a member of the consular post have come to an end, his privileges and immunities and those of a member of his family forming part of his household or a member of his private staff shall normally cease at the moment when the person concerned leaves the receiving state or on the expiry of a reasonable period in which to do so, whichever is the sooner, but shall subsist until that time, even in case of armed conflict. In the case of the persons referred to in paragraph 2 of this article, their privileges and immunities shall come to an end when they cease to belong to the household or to be in the service of a member of the consular post provided, however, that if such persons intend leaving the receiving state within a reasonable period thereafter, their privileges and immunities shall subsist until the time of their departure. 4. However, with respect to acts performed by a consular officer or consular employee in the exercise of his functions, immunity from jurisdiction shall continue to subsist without limitation of time. 5. In the event of the death of a member of the consular post, the members of his family forming part of his household shall continue to enjoy the privileges and immunities accorded to them until they leave the receiving state or until the expiry of a reasonable period enabling them to do so, whichever is the sooner. Article 54. Obligations of third states. 1. If a consular officer passes through or is in the territory of a third state, which has granted him a visa, if a visa was necessary, while proceeding to take up or return to his post or when returning to the sending state, the third state shall accord to him all immunities provided for by the other articles of the present convention as may be required to ensure his transit or return. The same shall apply in the case of any member of his family forming part of his household enjoying such privileges and immunities who are accompanying the consular officer or traveling separately to join him or to return to the sending state. 2. In circumstances similar to those specified in paragraph 1 of this article, third states shall not hinder the transit through their territory of other members of the consular post or of members of their families forming part of their households. 3. Third states shall accord to official correspondence and to other official communications in transit, including messages in code or cipher, the same freedom and protection as the receiving state is bound to accord under the present convention. They shall accord to consular couriers who have been granted a visa, if a visa was necessary, and to consular bags in transit, the same inviolability and protection as the receiving state is bound to accord under the present convention. 4. The obligations of third states under paragraphs 1, 2 and 3 of this article shall also apply to the persons mentioned respectively in those paragraphs, and to official communications and to consular bags, whose presence in the territory of the third state is due to force majeure. Article 55, respect for the laws and regulations of the receiving state. 1. Without prejudice to their privileges and immunities, it is the duty of all persons enjoying such privileges and immunities to respect the laws and regulations of the receiving state. They also have a duty not to interfere in the internal affairs of the state. 2. The consular premises shall not be used in any manner incompatible with the exercise of consular functions. 3. The provisions of paragraph 2 of this article shall not exclude the possibility of offices of other institutions or agencies being installed in part of the building in which the consular premises are situated, provided that the premises assigned to them are separate from those used by the consular post. In that event, the said offices shall not, for the purposes of the present convention, be considered to form part of the consular premises. Article 56, insurance against third-party risks. Members of the consular post shall comply with any requirements imposed by the laws and regulations of the receiving state in respect of insurance against third-party risks arising from the use of any vehicle, vessel or aircraft. Article 57, Special Provisions Concerning Private Gainful Occupation. 1. Career consular officers shall not carry on for personal profit any professional or commercial activity in the receiving state. 2. Privileges and immunities provided in this chapter shall not be accorded, a. to consular employees or to members of the service staff who carry on any private gainful occupation in the receiving state, b. to members of the family of a person referred to in subparagraph a. of this paragraph or to members of his private staff, c. to members of the family of a member of a consular post who themselves carry on any private gainful occupation in the receiving state.